The Razer Joro is a really interesting keyboard that's designed for both gamers and productivity users alike. In this video, we're going to take a look at all the special features that Razer has packed into this, who this is for, and who should maybe steer clear of this and get a different keyboard instead. I do want to say Razer sent me this keyboard for free to review. They've got no input in this content, and this is going to be based on my thoughts on the Joro and who I think this is for. This is a Scissor Switch keyboard with great Bluetooth performance, and you can also get a USB dongle as well. And I was really surprised that this has a tactile feel to the keys while still being super thin. So this is a very lightweight keyboard, and it also has an aluminum top on it, so it has no flex to it whenever you twist it. It feels very sturdy. So it's quiet and it feels really good to type on, and you've also got Razer's full RGB customization that you can use with their Synapse app. It can be paired to up to 3 devices at the same time using the device pairing buttons on the top. You can change back and forth between them just by pressing and holding for a second, or put it in pairing mode by pressing and holding for longer, and then the light will start to blink to show you that it's now in Bluetooth pairing mode. Also, if you want, you can always change it to wired mode on the back and use it with the USB-C cable. You can also recharge the battery on this with the USB-C port. You can customize all the RGB effects using the app, and you can either make it always stay the same color or cycle through a bunch of colors or go back and forth between 2 colors. Of course, you can also change the brightness of the backlighting as well. This is a 75% key layout, and I found that overall it was pretty comfortable, but there's a couple of choices they made that I didn't really like. The first one is the command keys are pretty small on this, and the space bar is also pretty short when you compare it to some of the other keyboards on the market. Also, the globe key is on this for Mac, but the globe key actually activates Hypershift mode, and you'll see the keyboard turns white. You can really customize this using the Razer Synapse app, where you can have custom key bindings when you press function, and you can reprogram any key on it, so not just the function row on the top. So this basically turns it into 2 keyboards in one with tons of macros. For gaming, this brings Razer SnapTap, which is their advanced input priority system. So Razer Synapse 4 allows you to turn on SnapTap, which will instantly cancel a previous key input when you press a new one, which gives you faster execution time in games. So if you're holding down a key like A and you want to press D to move to the other side, normally this would create an overlap causing your character to stop, but SnapTap detects the opposing inputs, and instead of stopping, it's going to register the last key you pressed as the active one. Also, it weighs just 0.8 pounds and measures about 16.5 millimeters in thickness. So this is super lightweight and won't take up much space in your backpack, but it doesn't feel hollow at all due to the aluminum alloy top plate on it and the durable construction with it. So I feel like it's really solid and very tactile when you're actually going to type on it. It is a 75% form factor layout, which is going to give you a full function row on the top. You also get full-size arrow keys as well as page up, page down, home, and end. One thing that is a little annoying though is your media skip keys are actually tied to the page up, page down, home, and end, so you'll have to use function if you want to activate those, which takes a little bit of getting used to as a Mac user, but I guess it's not the end of the world. One thing I don't really like about this though is those device pairing buttons are locked to F1, F2, and F3, so you can't reprogram those and you can't do screen brightness on your computer with those. So the layout of it is a little weird. Of course, you can always reprogram it, but I really like some of the keyboards that use Q, W, and E as the device pairing buttons. I just think that's really handy, but I can see how with the gaming features on this, that could maybe get in your way to have that as well. The keycaps are smooth and they also shine through, so the Chroma RGB can really shine through on this. I like the feel of the keys, but while filming this, I also definitely noticed the keys smudge really easily. So if that's something that bothers you, just be prepared to clean this keyboard. So for a keyboard this thin, the key travel is really nice. It feels very tactile. I love the feel of this. It's got a little bit of resistance and a very satisfying subtle sound that makes it feel almost like a tactile mechanical keyboard, but with that convenience and quiet sound of a Scissor style switch. So you don't have to be worried about volume with this because the volume is pretty quiet, which makes this a great choice even for busy office use or for on-the-go use. This is designed to be used on both Windows and Mac, and if you want, you can change between the Windows and Mac layout just by pressing function and tab at the same time. But just be aware that the overall arrangement does feel a little different from your standard Mac layout, but I was able to get used to it pretty quickly. Really, the biggest drawback to this for Mac users is the fact that the globe key actually will activate the Hypershift mode where you can use your different macros on it, so you can't use the tiling shortcuts with this, which I did find to be a little bit of a letdown. Also, you will need to put the Synapse application on this if you want to unlock all customization like key remapping and full control over the customizable Chroma RGB for the keyboard. I will say one thing that's a little bit of a letdown is you can only choose one color for this, so you can't make individual keyboard effects on this. Also, a couple other things I noticed, the shift key is a little bit small due to the full size arrow keys and the additional buttons on the right side. And this also does not include the 2.4 gigahertz hyperspeed wireless dongle right out of the box, which is a little bit of a letdown because they're really advertising the fast polling rate that you can get with that dongle, but you'll need to get one of their mouse options or buy that separately if you want to use it with that. Battery life is one area where the Joro does suffer. So if you use the backlighting, you're only gonna get 5 hours of use out of this. If you put it in the power saving mode, then you'll get up to 1800 hours of battery life, but that's gonna disable SnapTap and Synapse and lower the polling rate as well. You also can expect to get 1200 hours of battery life with this if you shut off the backlighting, but you don't put it in the power save mode. The Razer Joro comes in at $130. And with this keyboard, you're really paying for the RGB, the tactile scissor style switches, the lightweight size, the aluminum top on it, and also the gaming specific functionality. If you need a powerful, responsive, and comfortable low profile keyboard that'll work great for either a PC or Mac setup, then the Joro will be a great option for you. It's great whether you want to use it in an office setting, for gaming, or also take it on the go with you. If you're interested in buying the Razer Joro, I'll have links to buy in the description below. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content, and if you've got any other questions about this, leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear them.